Hello, welcome along to Nice and the second in our programs from the World Figure Skating Championships in the year 2000. It's been a fantastic day and we've already enjoyed some superb performances in the men's qualifying. If you weren't with us earlier on today, want to hear excuses later, but Alexei Yagodin leads in the men's A group from Michael Weiss of America, then Cheng Yang Li from China. And in the B group, it's Elvis Stoiko in the lead from Evgeny Pashenko and Alexander Apt. The top 15 from each group qualify, and it means that Matthew Davis, who finished in 15th place in Stoiko's group, he goes through, so that's very good news. And now it's the pairs short, the first stage of the pairs competition, counting 33% of the overall mark. The judges just being introduced to the crowd here, around 4,000 or 5,000 in the Palais des Expositions, part of the big Acropolis Centre here in Nice. It's been a wonderful day. Temperature around 20 degrees centigrade. And we've had a great time. Can't have it all. Alongside me is Chris Howes.
Thank you for that wonderful introduction, Mr. Reed.
No problem. Big talking point here, of course, is the withdrawal. You may have seen it in Sports Centre of Bereshnaya and Sigolitsi, the world champions for the last 2 years. They've had to withdraw because Elena was found to have tested positive for a stimulant at the European Championships in Vienna. Now, the Russian Federation had the chance to appeal, but they more or less assumed that the second sample would be the same as the first and it would be positive as well, and so they have decided to withdraw. The official reason from Bereshnaya and Sigolitsi is that they took it as a medicine for a cough. And everyone here is taking that very seriously indeed. Unfortunately, it does break the rules. We've just seen a press conference with Tamara Moskvina, their coach, who says that the worst that she was remiss, because maybe she should have known what was in the cough mixture, but nothing had happened before with the same cough mixture. And they've had to withdraw, which is devastating, or catastrophic, as Tamara herself describes it. It's very unfortunate indeed. And indeed, we also hear that Natalia Ponomareva and Evgeny Sviridov from Uzbekistan will not be competing either, for the same reason, for a stimulant at the European Championships. And, well, it's particularly sad, of course, for Bereshnaya and Sigolitsi, going for a three-timer here, Chris.
Yeah, it is. They're in good form and would have been firm favourites in this pairs competition. But, of course, it leaves the door open now for the other skaters. It's still going to be a great competition, but bitterly disappointing for those two to have to sit on the sidelines and watch the competition evolve.
So now we're down to 22 pairs. And the three in the opening group here, Catherine Hook and Vivian Roland from France, then Dorota Zagorska and Mariusz Sudek from Poland, bronze medalists last year, and then Olga Bestandigova and Josef Bestandig, the brother and sister from Slovakia. Those are the three out there on the ice at the moment. And as we go further down, remember the main competitors here are from France, from China, from the States and from Canada. In the second group, we have Berankova and Dlabala from the Czech Republic, who will have a thing or two to say. Then in the third group, it's Sarah Abitbol and Stefan Bernardy from France, Peggy Schwartz and Mirko Muller from Germany, and the Canadians Christy Sargent and Chris Wirtz. Then in the fourth group, Zhu Zhen and Hongbo Zhao, second to Bereshnaya and Sigolitsi last year in Helsinki. So they're the favourites going into this competition. None of the top competitors are in the fifth group. In the final group, feast of riches. Kyoko Ina and John Zimmerman from the States, Mayuria Petrova and Alexei Tikhonov from Russia, and Jamie Sale and David Pelletier from Canada. Newcomers on the scene, very promising too. They go in the final group. That just about sets it up, and the end of the warm-up for this opening group in the pairs short program. So it's France, followed by Poland, followed by Slovakia in this opening group. And we begin, and great to hear this roar. Around 6,000 inside here now, the Palais des Expositions. The couple who are third in French nationals this year. She's just 16, he's 22. From Toulouse, Catherine Houck, and from Rémin, Vivian Roland. Split twist and a good one to start. And as Chris will tell you, this is all about this short program, all about deductions.
It certainly is. There's eight required elements throughout this 2 minute and 40 second program. And there's the second, and unfortunately a fall there for Catherine. They can perform side by side double or triple jumps there.
0.3404.
Now the throw. Much better, good girl. Throw triple salco.
Good synchronicity on the side-by-side spins.
Side-by-side spin tonight must have one change of foot and at least one change of position. Good position in the lift. Step sequence that can be done in a straight line, circle or serpentine pattern.
Great way to start the evening off. Hope you enjoy that at home. Good driving music called Drivers by Larry Garner, and very well performed out there on the ice, except for that opening move, which of course will cost them dear. 0.3 off for the fall. Fully paid up members here, whereas earlier on today a lot of kids let him free. But this is well supported. Nice was second choice for these World Championships this year. Brisbane were the opening bidders, but they couldn't get a television contract together, so it came to Nice. French Federation bid high and bid well, and here's the result.
Certainly seems to be a well-organized event. And here's a look at that one error in that program. Just keep your eye on her. Double axel, 2.5 turns in the air. Didn't get the height, not quite making the rotation. You could see landing on the toe rake. The skate going forwards couldn't stop the rotation there. Here's a throw triple salco. She did well here because the confidence wouldn't have been high, but really nailed that landing. And the lift, the hip lift, and you'll see a variation of positions performed during this program.
France has a rich tradition in practically all aspects of figure skating, but not in pairs, and then suddenly we have the arrival of Bernardi and Abbott Boll, and the horizons go up for pairs like this. Who've only been together 18 months. Boy, haven't they made a strong advance. I would think they could get very far indeed, Chris, in the future.
Yeah, a lot of talent there. And she showed she's got a lot of bottle. Because it's always unnerving when you get out there and you fall on your solo jump and then get propelled into the air at the speed that these girls do and land that triple salco. It's good stuff. Difficult to really appreciate on the television just how far and how fast the skaters are going when they land those throw jumps. If they get it wrong, it can be very, very nasty indeed.
So here are the marks. First for the elements, and then for presentation. Now they're going to be low because they're the first to go. The crowd don't particularly like this because you know where they come from. 3.6 up to 4.1.
Marks for presentation.
4.2 up to 4.4. So that's the standard the others have to improve on. Hook and Roland, the first of the 22 couples to go. Next to go, the couple who finished in third place last year in Helsinki, and they were bronze medalists in Vienna just last month. One of the most experienced couples around, but they are still improving. From Poland, Dorota Zagoska and Mariusz Sudziak. Most Polish pairs to win a medal at Worlds when they won the bronze last year. What can they do this year? Start that twist. Now the side-by-side jump. Yep, triple toe loop. Great picture with that perfect synchronization. Throw triple salco. They're razor sharp.
That's all the big elements out of the way now. They can just sell the program.
Assured for me there than at any other stage in their career. It's amazing what success will do. It just breeds success and confidence, and they do just get better and better. And it's interesting, with Berezhnar and Sigalidze out of the way, it just opens the horizon that little bit more, doesn't it?
Yeah, there's a little bit extra to skate for now, I think. And these two, you just feel that they've got their sights set on Salt Lake City. They really are getting better and better every year. That was such an assured performance. Wonderful start to the program, the split double twist. Look at this. Well, that's textbook. He caught her easily. Onto one foot to put her down. Here's the side-by-side triple toe loops. They don't have the same timing on the way in, but they sort of adjust the three turn to suit each other's timing. A real team effort, this. Combination spin at the end. who work so well together. And he felt from the moment that they stepped onto the ice that they weren't going to put a foot wrong. The inside death spiral. Good position. She's very, very low. And such a difficult entry into that hip lift. Well, it's going to take some beating.
Yes, they're unfortunate, and they've gone so early, so the marks will be a little muted. They have to be. They know that. They're experienced enough to know that they wouldn't hit the roof early on. What it means is that the marks all through this evening will be relatively low, lower than they would have been if Sogorska and Sudik had gone maybe in an hour's time. The judges have to do that. 5-4 up to 5.7, and presumably a little bit higher for presentation. Just a fraction. So first, right across the board, that is the new standard, and it'll be very difficult, as Chris intimated, to be bettered.
Thank you.
Exciting stuff. And now we move to the couple from Slovakia, a good deal younger, a good deal less experienced, although they've been competing now in World Championships. This is their third year. Brother and sister from Bratislava. Side of next year's Europeans. Olga Bestandigova and Josef Bestandig. From the Art of Noise, Dragnet. Double-footed, I'm afraid, from Olga on that side-by-side triple toe. Point two off for that.
Doubling out on the throw there. They've left it awfully late in the program.
It's a pity about the double at the end, because the tariff will be a lot lower for that. took Bestandig over, and Bestandig looking very sharp. It's been a high standard at the start of this performance.
Certainly has. Well, there'll be no deductions for doubling out on the throw at the end of the programme, but nevertheless, as you rightly said, Simon, the tariff will be lower. And you just feel that perhaps they put it in at the end of the programme because they weren't confident with it, didn't want it to affect the rest of the programme if anything did go wrong. Here's the side-by-side triple toes at the beginning. If you keep your eye on her, you can see that only just made the rotation, didn't have a lot of elevation, and had to scramble at the end to keep on her feet. Nothing too ambitious in the lift, but a good position in that star lift position there. And this was part of the step sequence. Novel little move. I'd say there was a beaty choice of music, a little bit difficult to interpret when you consider that in the short program pretty much all the competitors will be doing the same elements. It's important to come up with a good choice of program, one that really suits your style of skating and something that you can really get into and get some good musical interpretation in there.
It's Gorska and Zurich who lead, and they won't be threatened by this couple. They are going to slot into second place above the French, who went early, 3.6 up to 4.1. Lucky and Judge marking them reasonably high, but not affecting their placing. So pretty close, 5-4, but they beat the French fractionally. She gets your message as well, Chris, which is heartening.
Thank you.
So Zagorska and Zudek are the leaders. And we move to the next group, which has couples from Estonia, China, and the Czech Republic, but there's confirmation that Zagorska and Zudek lead. Yes, Chris, in skating terms, the buzz right round the rink has been the withdrawal of the Russian couple. All sorts of rumours abounding, and not confirmed, but a genuine gossip here is that they have been given a 3-month ban for Elena testing positive. I have to say, when you think of her, we're going to see later on the highlights of she and Anton winning the world championship last year, and when you see that, it's almost impossible to think of this little thing using a stimulant as an advantage, and I'm absolutely sure in my own mind that she didn't. But the rules are rules. They made a mistake. She's tested positive, and it has to be done.
I think it's pretty much sent shockwaves across the sport, and I think most people think like you that, you know, it's incredibly sad and unbelievable to think that anything could have been underhand there. I'm sure it was an innocent mistake, and they've learned a tough lesson.
Yes, and their coach.
Absolutely, Tamara. It's amazing, isn't it, when you think of the experience that Tamara's got to make that sort of mistake.
We had to come up here. Obviously, there was a press conference going on as we were preparing the last few minutes for this broadcast, but she was apparently saying that she might have been remiss, and I think she felt a little bit of guilt because obviously she's the experienced campaigner in that camp, but she hadn't had to deal with anything like that in the past. A cough mixture is what we understand to be the guilty factor in it.
Yeah, I'm sure it's very difficult. All the athletes have to check thoroughly exactly what they're taking for any illnesses. And that's why it's so important to go to the team doctor if you can. A bitter disappointment, and disappointing for the fans that have come here in the hope of seeing Bereshnaya skate.
Yeah, and Sigurdsson.
Oh, and Sigurdsson.
Not to be too sexist about this. But they are the class act. I mean, they're going to have immense competition here. And they may not have won. very possibly may not have won, but they were the favourites coming in. They were breathtaking, weren't they, in Vienna?
They certainly were, and, you know, win or lose, it's just great to see them out there on the ice. Always adds so much to a competition. And just looking at the way this one started, it's going to be a real battle royal.
No British couple here. But that's been par for the course in the last few years.
Yeah, I think the British couple competed at European Championships. It was a learning experience for them, and they'll have gained great experience from competing there. But they've got a lot of work to do, and they know that. And they'll be working their socks off back home for next season.
None of the couples in this particular group will threaten for a medal, although the Chinese pair are improving rapidly. It'll be very interesting to see how they go. Belenkova and Dlabala from the Czech Republic haven't been in the top 10 yet in World Championships, although they've done pretty well in Europeans, 7th in 99 and 9th this year in Vienna. Just a reminder, the next group after this, we're going to have a reservice, and the group after this, you will see many of the big names coming up. Abbott Boland, Benadi, Peggy Schwartz and Mirko Muller, Christy Sargent and Chris Wirtz. And also in the reservices, we're going to be very busy showing you highlights of last year's first two couples, Berezhnaya and Sigalidze. And also we'll show you Zhu Shen and Hongbo Zhao from China. We'll show you their free program from last year, which won them the silver medal in Helsinki. And in the second resurface, we'll show you highlights from the qualification, the two winning performances from Stoyko and Yagudin, winners in their respective groups. Now there are Zhu Zhen and Hongbo Zhao, winner of the Grand Prix series this year. Sorry, it's Qing Pang and Yan Tong who were runners-up to Zhen and Zhao. But very promising.
They certainly are. With the Chinese at the moment, you just don't know what to expect. And look at the height on that throw triple salchow, which he couldn't control the landing, but that gives you an idea of what you've got, what's in store here. Phenomenal talent. Here's a look at that again from a different angle. See the energy he puts into it. And it is so difficult for the girls to stop the rotation and keep control. The length of those throws and the speed that they're going at when they hit the ground is quite unbelievable. It really does make the sport very, very spectacular.
And we have seen disappointing nights, haven't we, in the pair short?
Yeah, we have. There's so much pressure out there. And the couples are pushing themselves to the absolute limit.
This is just about the weakest group list. Don't expect the standard necessarily to improve as we go through. It's a random draw, and the top skaters could be drawn anywhere.
Ladies and gentlemen, the warm-up is over. Would you please clear the ice? Thank you.
So that's the end of the warm-up for this group. And remember, competitors from Estonia, China, and the Czech Republic. Start off with the couple in picture now in this second group. 11th in Vienna, a big rise for them. They've improved immensely. She's just 16 years old, he's 20, from Tallinn in Estonia. Victoria Shklova and Valdis Mintals. Soundtrack from the movie Gremlins. They call it Gremlins Rag. Good start. Split double twist. side-by-side triple toes. A neat beginning. And a throw triple Salco.
Well, she spotted the landing of that very well indeed. And if anything, Chris, I think their talent demands a slightly more difficult program because they did that so easily. They did the key elements early on, and I think they could stretch themselves just a little bit higher. Well, there's the argument, isn't there, to come in there and just gain the experience and do what you know you can do cleanly and get a good program under your belt, and I think that's probably what they've opted for. But you're dead right. I mean, they're very, very talented. They've come out here on the big stage and perform very, very well indeed. Look forward to seeing the triple toes again, because I think her rotation was a little slow, not quite sure whether she made it completely. And of course, the judges have got the advantage now of their instant replay systems, which they'll be using. Just keep your eye on her here. This is the triple toe. Yeah, she landed forwards on 2 feet, so there will be deductions there.
Sure.
But nevertheless, there was a lot to admire.
Well done, Hawkeye.
But hey.
Hey, that's what you're paid for. That kind of insight.
That you brought me along for something. Good lift. They seemed to really enjoy it out there as well, didn't they?
Yes, they did. There was no sense of the intensity of the occasion. Again, we were talking about it earlier on in the men's qualifying. Success breeds confidence, which breeds success. They did well in Vienna, 11th. Who knows what they're going to do today? They were 20th. In their best ever showing at Worlds back in 98. Don't they look happy? Immense potential there. .6 from the French seems very low. I know it's early on, but I think that's outrageous, to be honest. Up to 4.3.
Thank you.
Certainly the lady alongside, that you may remember her, Anna Kondrasheva, former world-class single skater. Yes, second. Except for the French, who has them in fourth place below, would you believe, the French. Now it all makes sense. But it doesn't make it any better to swallow. Next to go, the couple who were second in Chinese senior championships. Remember who won Chinese seniors, Yu Shen and Hongbo Zhao. Both 20 years old, these two from Harbin province. Immense talent again, Qing Pang and Jiang Tong. fifth in the Four Continents Championship. She held on to that.
Just incredible length on that throw, triple salchow.
It was very nearly half the width of the rink. Oh, she got it all wrong on the side-by-side triple. And I'm afraid we talk about deductions, they're key, and that will really hurt.
Split double twist.
Mentioned earlier on the previous couple, Glover and Mintals, who I suspected skated a program which was well within them. I'm not sure that that was the reverse there with King Pang and Yang Tong. Enormous elements, and I'm surprised that she lands the jump. She's got such skinny legs, no muscle at all. It's remarkable that she could land the throw jump.
Yeah, she must be very, very strong though. I don't think we'll see a throw triple salchow any longer than that this evening.
No.
It was enormous, and she had to really hang on to the toe rake on the landing. Watch it again. Look at that. He almost loses his balance as he throws her, and she had to grind into the toe pick. Here's a triple toe. She didn't get a good firm footing on the takeoff of that, and only just about made two turns. But watch this. Again, amazing elevation. Some first class elements, but a couple of errors in there. I love the concept of the program.
Yes, daring and taking them to the extreme.
Yeah, there really is nothing of her at all, is there?
Absolutely nothing.
So strong.
Concept here in Nice. We've got wide screens at opposite ends of the rink, and the spectators here enjoying the replays just as you are here. Spectators getting added benefit, and more congratulations to the ISU.
It's pretty much a packed house here now.
It is. Yeah, it's 7:45 local time, and I would think around to, well, nearly 6,000 now. The Continental Centre don't like that. 4-5 up to 5-0.
Thank you. Marks for presentation.
And it's going to slot them in second place, right across the board. So Zagorska and Sudek lead, Pang and Dong second, and Chklovram and Talsom Estonia are third. Last go in this second group, a couple from the Czech Republic in ninth place, that's where they finished in Vienna. Best in Worlds, 12th in Helsinki last year. Music from the soundtrack of Lawrence of Arabia. For the couple from Brno, Katalina Barankova and Otto de Labla. Afraid from Katarina on the side-by-side triple toe.
I have to say she did well, awful lean on that triple toe loop.
And another 0.3 off, I'm afraid, on the throw triple salco. So any high hopes these two had, I'm afraid, gone already. The Czechs had a world champion in the pairs event back in 1995 with Radka Kvorikova and Renée Novotný, and they're still looking in vain for successors to that. And at the moment, from that kind of form, it doesn't look like Katarina and Otto are going to fit the bill.
It looked a bit of a battle that tonight. They never really settled down and got into the program. She will have been rocked somewhat by the hand down on the triple toe at the beginning. Here's a look at that again. You can see she's got a heck of a lean on it and did well to stay upright at all. There's the triple salco. Now, this wasn't bad at all. You can see that she grits her teeth. Could have got the left leg back, I'm sure. Perhaps if the triple toe at the beginning had been better, she'd have landed that triple salco. Amazing flexibility there in that hip lift. But she made the two crucial errors, but even he throughout the program looked a little scratchy and not in the normal control that we're used to. Good timing there. You can see him really watching on every rotation just to make sure. that split double twist, not a lot of height on that. And he should be on one foot as he puts her down. He was a little late there. Again, the forward inside death spiral. She could get a bit lower. He could get down into that pivot more. Just make life a little easier for her.
It's their third World Championships together. Moved from 14th to 12th, and they're looking for a place in the top 10 here. Well, not good, I'm afraid. 4-3 up to 4-7, and remember the marks have been pretty low all the way through. Well, there you are, they're in second place. I must say I'm surprised again. Some of the marking here, I must say I'm finding it a little difficult to cope with. But there you are, they're in second place. Oh, I'm not sure. So a resurface right now, and we'll just keep you right up to date with what we've seen. It's Agorska and Zudek leading. The Slovakians down in fifth place, the Estonians fourth, and Berenkova and Labala even in front of the Chinese.
I think they've been given a present.
I'm glad you said that.
Yeah, it's a strange result that. Still a long way to go.
When I saw the marks, I wasn't surprised. Then I realized there'd been low marks all the way through, and that they're second. There you are. Right, you won't miss a thing. Plenty of recorded stuff during the commercials. And you'll be back with us in a moment. And back live with us now for the warm-up for...